When I came out to LA, I started in the mailroom and I worked at a music management company. And it was called The Firm. I don't know if you
I
remember that
do
back
know
in the
of that.
day. And yeah, I was delivering mail. And on the side, I was reading these books about real estate. And I was talking to all these people that were in real estate and they were making lots of money. And I said, Matt, you know, we got to get into real estate. And he's like, well, how are we going to get into real estate? We don't have any money. And so for the next year, we saved up every dollar we made. I had 5 grand saved to my name. Matt had 5 grand saved to his name. We put it together. We took that 10 grand and we went into a bank and we got something called 100% financing, which doesn't exist anymore. And we took that 10 grand and we bought a $400,000 condo. And we moved into the condo. Every paycheck we got for the next probably 8 weeks, we would do something different to the condo. First paycheck, we go to Home Depot, get paint. Next paycheck, we change out a light fixture. Next paycheck, we put in a new appliance. Whatever it was, like that, 3 months into it, we sold the house, the sold the condo for 600 grand. So we made 200 grand in 3 months.
And was that the first time that you were
That
like,
was it.
ah, this is my thing?
So I said, whoa, I'm in the mailroom making $6.50 an hour. We just made 200 grand.
Were you still working in the
Oh,
mailroom?
I was in the mailroom, still
Ah,
working in the
man.
mailroom. I made that 200 grand and I'm telling you, I thought I was a millionaire.
Of course.
Okay, you get that money, you're like, I'm rich.
Yes, I
It was
love that.
more money than I had ever seen.
I always talk about like the first payday or the first, you know what I mean? Because it's hard to match that feeling. I
You
bet
can't.
now if you got $1 million tomorrow just given to you for something, it would not feel anywhere near. Sorry, let me
Drama,
say
I would be.
$10
Hold on,
million.
hold on. Let's get something straight. If someone gives me $1 million or $10 million, I'm stoked.
I
All
bet you
right.
are.
I will get that feeling back. I promise you.
The same as the 200? Oh man. What I always that's good then. Because you know what I always find is like that first 200, you are like, oh my God, like not only am I filthy rich, I'm a genius. Nobody can tell me anything. I will never see a bad day in my life. And I have figured out how to hack real estate more than anyone else in
It was
history.
unbelievable, you know. Oh my God. That 200 grand, it just changed the game. It opened up the opportunity in our minds that wow, we can do this. We can be successful. It showed other people that we can be successful. And in our eyes, we were the two biggest developers in the history of Los
There
Angeles
you go.
because we did one little flip.
That's that feeling.
So we took that 200 grand. I didn't even have a car at the time. I actually would rollerblade back and forth to the mailroom every day.
You're lying.
Yeah, no, I swear.
You'd
It was
strap on fucking
Yeah,
rollerblades?
and by the way, this was before skateboarding was like, you
I
know,
get it.
where it's at. So
Yeah,
rollerblades were
right.
cool.
How long ago was this?
Rollerblades were cool,
This
bro.
is like 8 years ago.
It's not 8 years ago.
How
This was
old are you?
2001. All right.
Listen, skateboarding existed in
I know, but it
2001.
not in my world. Not in my world. So
And rollerblading was already whack in 2001, just for the
the record, all right, we're gonna change the story right now. We're never gonna repeat
So
that.
I got my
So
skateboard.
I used to skateboard back and forth to the mailroom. So after I got that check, I rollerbladed to the Jeep dealership. I bought myself a Jeep Cherokee because that was my dream car at the time. And yeah, and that was it. And then I drove to my mailroom job in the new car and I quit. And I took the
I
rest of
love
the
that you bought the Jeep first and then you
I got
quit.
the Jeep because I didn't have time to rollerblade there and then rollerblade there.
Yeah,
You
it's
know
rich guy problems. You know, now
what?
that you're rich, it's like you got to schedule your days different.
That was it. So, you know, got to the quit. And then at that point, I thought I was a full-time developer, even though I literally did one flip.
But what do you do like on the next day, right? So I'm just picturing sell this thing, oh my God, get the check, buy the Jeep, quit the job, and then it's like,
Okay, so now we called up our realtor because we weren't realtors. Called up my realtor and I said, all right, let's find another one. And we went searching and we eventually found another one. The next one was 700,000. We flipped it 6 months later for 900,000.
Were you living in them too?
Oh yeah, my brother and I, we would move in, live out of the suitcase, fix the houses while we were in them, and then sell them.
Got it.
And it was easy, you know, it's just my brother and I in a suitcase each.
Yeah.
And that was it. And we kept on doing that. And by like the fifth or sixth, I was like, you know what? It's all about the bottom line. I got to get my real estate license.
Yeah.
And I did. I became a mortgage broker because I wanted to learn the finance side. Started very slow in that business, but worked my way up. Ended up being the top sales guy in the company. And eventually opened up my own mortgage company, started killing it. I mean, we were making money hand over fist.
Guys, if you like that and you want to see more like it, as well as vlogs, other web series, and all the random stuff that I'm doing here on YouTube, don't forget to click that subscribe button. You won't regret it, I promise.